Welcome to InfOT. Today, we will talk about the role of assistive technology in occupational therapy. It is widely known that technological development in recent years is constantly shaping the world around us. Especially after the outbreak of the COVID-19 pandemic, this development was rapid and led to the application of technological achievements in various areas of health, such as telehealth, telemedicine, automation in houses, and more. As occupational therapists, we are responsible for devices and technologies that can improve independence, autonomy, and social participation of individuals in daily life. In this context, the term assistive technology was born, which refers to any object that helps the person do something that they could not otherwise do. Assistive technology is an important tool used by occupational therapists to improve the independence and quality of life of individuals who face challenges in their daily lives. With assistive technology, occupational therapists enable individuals to develop new skills, retrain and regain functionality they have lost due to their disability or injury. Through assistive technology, occupational therapists can help individuals develop their physical, sensory, cognitive and social skills, as well as improve their independence and quality of life. Assistive technology provides occupational therapists and individuals in need of therapy with a wide range of tools and resources to perform various activities and achieve specific goals. Which are the types of assistive technology? Assistive technology as a field is very broad and includes thousands of devices. However, for the sake of brevity, these devices are divided into high assistive technology and low assistive technology. Low assistive technology can, for example, be some simple communication cards, while special computers are high assistive technology. For high assistive technology, the contribution of a specialist occupational therapist or engineer, speech therapist or others is needed for its correct prescription and use. Assistive technology can include assistive tools such as artificial equipment prostheses, fixed or mobile devices, digital applications and software specifically designed for people with disabilities. Let's review now some examples of assistive technology. In assistive technology for vision difficulties, we might use magnifiers, braille displays, reading apps, or phones with large buttons. In assistive technology, for hearing difficulties, we could use wireless hearing systems, vibrating alarm clocks, lighted doorbells, or captioned phones. In assistive technology for communication limitations, we usually use communication tables, artificial larynx, or voice symbol production application. In assistive technology for cognitive skills, we have memory aids, note reminder systems, audiobooks, or special mobile apps. In assistive technology for mobility, there are wheelchairs, walkers, canes, crutches, power wheelchairs, adapted buttons, ramps, or adapted seatbelts. In assistive technology for daily life, some examples include clothing aids, ramps, and others. Who can benefit from assistive technology? According to the current literature, assistive technology can be beneficial for all people who suffer from a disability or have functional limitations in their daily life. Among other things, assistive technology can significantly help students of all ages and all school levels, as well as children with dexterity difficulties. Furthermore, research supports the use of assistive technology in people with dementia, in children with disabilities, in post-stroke patients, in autistic people, and so many others. What are the advantages of assistive technology? The benefits of using assistive technology have been extensively researched and appear to include, among others, increased positive self-concept, autonomy, adaptability and self-worth, reduced levels of irritation, reduced time needing assistance, improved quality of life, and reduced time the patient spends alone and changes in social relationships. Assistive technology can also reduce or eliminate restriction on participation in activities, promote inclusion, provide equal opportunities for participation in the project and everyday life, enhance the quality of life, increase independence and self-care of the individual, promote a restriction-free environment, and increase self-confidence. Are there any disadvantages when using assistive technology? The biggest obstacles that someone can face during the use of assistive technology, or even before it, when prescribing it, are usually the following. Frequently, there is an absence of the material due to the manufacturer or due to low demand. The cost is high and there is not always financial support from the client's insurance. Moving the material can be difficult. It may be from another country or its size is very large. The experience of the occupational therapist is also important, and if it is not there, it can limit the client's options. There is not always adequate support for the client and his family. The occupational therapist's knowledge of what material is available may be limited. Approval in the respective location of the device, for example in a school, may be delayed or never granted. The client's preference, refusal to use assistive technology. All information in this video was found here. Thank you for watching InfoT. If you liked the video, feel free to like and subscribe. Stay tuned for more.